my cutest of all cutinesses. Today, I have for you Nr3 in my 10 party looks. I love this one. It's completely brown and gold and copper and glitter and glam and nothing black except for the lashes. So, without eyeliner or any further ado, if you want to see how I did this makeup look, you'll just have to keep on watching as it's getting started right now. Oh, and if you wouldn't have noticed, I got a new background. Look at that. Yay! If the fire was as hot as it looked, I would have melted on my chair. But thank God it's a fake. So, let's begin with the makeup. Hello, 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 my cuties. I don't know what's happening. I have got my beautiful new background, which is a chimney and stockings and little Christmas lights. But what my animals are planning on doing, I don't know. Odie absolutely definitely wanted to sit on my lap. But I don't know how I'm gonna do makeup with him on my lap. But Wipke is also here, and he is in my plants. And I think Odie wants to be on the window shield here. Let me think, maybe I can put a pillow up there so they can be there both. I will be right back. I am going to let my baby sit next to me when I do my makeup, yeah! Okay, I'm back in front of my chimney, but the fire isn't on because it's freezing here. But okay, from now on you will see me doing my makeup here. Ooh, ooh, boop-a-doo, ooh, 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 yeah! What's wrong with me today? I feel so happy. I'm in a lot of pain. Nothing's going well today, but it all turns out well in the end. Everything starts like I lost my memory card and this happened and that happened and nothing was happening like I wanted it to. But then I found it, and then this happened, and then that happened. So, now, today, I want to do a wonderful brown and gold party look. But I'm going to start off with taking care of this baby here, of our face, before we apply our heavy party makeup. Because, as we know, we all are in a hurry to get ready to go party. Oh, ah, yeah, yeah, you, whoa, whoa, whoa. But we forget to do the best treatment for this baby. And it's gonna have to wear a lot of makeup because we're going to a lot of parties, I presume. I'm not going to any party, but you are. So, I want to show you today how you can do the best treatment and of course a party makeup with no black. No black eyeliner, no nothing in black. The only thing that's gonna be black are my lashes. Yeah, I don't have brown mascara. Sorry. Normally, we just start by using a primer. Well, that's not what we're gonna do. We're gonna use moisturizer, and in my case this is my normal moisturizer. It is, as you probably already know, based on snail extract. Sorry, it sounds gross, but it's a wonderful product. And I also use special anti-wrinkle drops because I need it, people. I'm old, you know, and I'm going to use a synthetic brush, and you'll say, why? She's got so many great, great quality brushes. Well, yes, I do. But with real hairs, Those real hairs are like our hairs. They soak up product. So what we absolutely want to avoid is that our brush sucks up all of our product and take on extra to get enough to put on our face. Now the first thing that I do is these drops for my wrinkles. Of course, you all beauty youngsters out there, you can skip this part, but I wouldn't. Because to prevent getting wrinkles later on in life, treat it now. Treat it from your 15 to 20 years old. Start using whatever your skin needs. Let a dermatologist or your pharmacist check out that you have the right product. I also do a little bit on my lips so that it gets all the time it needs to soak in. Now, for the rest of my face, I'm gonna use my Nutrition, but you can use any type of moisturizing oil, cream, whatever base it is that you use, by all means, use it. But what you now see is I layer this pretty thick onto my skin, but you will see in less than a minute it's all... and I scared the bird out of his plant. I'll have to pick him up and put him back in the plant, otherwise he's not gonna be very happy. I just put a little scared. Poor thing. Wipke, what happened, darling? Mommy's coming to get you, yes. But I'm just gonna apply this before it's already soaked up everywhere. Before I have applied it everywhere. I scared the bird out of the plant. Sorry. It was so hilarious to see him go. I'm so sorry, I'm gonna get the poor thing. Oh, I'm still in such excruciating pain, but I'm not gonna let it bother me to do makeup. So, now that I have done this, I can really feel my skin rejuvenate. Ding, we're getting fed, treated. I feel my skin being happy. And now I'm gonna use primer. Now my NYC New York color Smooth Skin Perfecting Primer in shade 684, which is, whoops, now all over the table. Sorry. Okay. I'm also gonna paint that, because this is like painting it on to my face. And this is gonna close all my pores. And it has got a little bit of shimmer in it, which will shine through my foundation if I don't put my foundation on too wildly. And as you see, I'm striking it from the inner part of my face to the edge of my face, so that I'm really painting full every pore and blemish that I've got. And as you see, this also gives a coating and moisturizes. And it's not that specifically silicone based, but it does give a nice layer. Now you know, this is taking a lot of time, but it's taking a lot of time because I'm taking a lot of time explaining. If you're used to do this ritual or this way of applying nice, good base to your makeup, it's flap, 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 it's on and it's okay. You can also moisturize your skin an hour in advance or whatever, but it's best to do it right before you apply your makeup. Now I'm going to my foundation, and my favorite one lately is actually the Hype liquid foundation number 4, but I also love this Stay All Day long lasting essence, and it's in the color 20 soft nude. I like these two a lot. This one's got a little bit of shimmer in it, but this is longer lasting. But I'm gonna mix these two together. So I'm gonna put in a pump of both products. A couple of pumps, as you see. And I'm gonna try to do the same amount with the essence one, which is very thick, and the other one is very liquid. So I'm gonna have a very thick, as you see, it stays in squeezed, squished shape, and the other one is more like a puddle. Now I'm taking the back of this brush and I'm gonna mix these two together because I'm too lazy to take my spatula. And everybody has got the back of the brush at hand. So mixing these two together is mixing a very long wear plus one with a little bit of shimmer in it. I'm just gonna clean off my brush and I'm gonna apply it with that brush, working from the inside part of my face again to the edges. Never leave a line at your hairline or here, because that makes me feel a little bit thick in the stomach. Now I am just applying with this brush, so it doesn't have to be perfect before I jump on it with a beauty blender. And always go into the clothesline. Too bad you'll have to do the laundry afterwards, but better to take good care of your makeup and look stunning than to stop along your jawline. Just do not get it anywhere. If you don't want that or like that, then don't wear makeup. I don't think I'm gonna get a lot of gifts from Santa because I'm naughty. I'm taking my beauty blender, it is damp, but I'm gonna use extra setting spray on it before I press all my foundation into place. And I start at the edges because there's the least product. And you can choose, either you let it soak itself full on the inner part of your face and you gently divide that to the edges, or you can start at the edges and work your way with no product into the full product. That is your own choice. I'm just doing it this way now. And I'm gently rolling, especially where I'm very wrinkled. There is something on my face here that does not belong there, and I don't know what it is. Get away, you. Go, go, go. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Okay, I think that will be enough. I think it's equally everywhere, and I'm gonna keep this just in case I need to touch up a little bit later on. You see, you know what I mean. Why am I talking like this? I got no idea. Now, to let this set before I put powder on it, I am gonna give it a spritz. This is now my e.l.f. makeup mist and set, but I'm gonna give it a little spritz already. And the mixture of these two foundations have really given it a superb glow. And before I am going to use my oh so favorite all time to be used BB powder, I am this time gonna do my concealer. And I've got myself a new one. Dream Lumi Touch Highlighting Concealer by Maybelline. And it's brand new. And I'm going to use it right on my wrinkles. And I'm going to use enough. And this is not too light, not too bright. Number one, nude. So it's not a very light or ivory or something like that. It's a nude, soft color. And what I like to do is buff this in with a special concealing brush. It's the one that I always use. And I'm going to, I'm just gently making it a little bit damp on my beauty blender so that it's not poking dry. And I'm gonna start buffing this concealer into my skin. I'm just dabbing. I'm gonna use my other, I think this one is gonna be completely empty, but I'm gonna try and see if there's still something coming out. But okay, it's as dead as it can be, so goodbye my darling, it's in the trash. So I'm taking my 123 Perfect CC Eye Cream by Bourjois in its color 21. I am going into my inner corner of my eye here, and I'm going to dab that from the middle part of the eye to my, yeah, temples. As you all know, I cannot set this with powder or anything, or I am a big ball of disaster. Now, I am going over, and especially around the edges, with the part where my foundation is on my beauty blender. And that's that. Now I'm gonna try to find my nude BB powder. I'm using my big fat fluffy brush, and I'm gonna start setting this with my BB. And that was Wipke, who thought he could get outside, but he bumped with his beak against the window. Now, as you see, I am setting this makeup inside my blouse too, so the powder will be more easy to come off. And I'm feathering just a little bit of powder, but the tiniest amount, over my under eye area. If I do more, you know. Now, what are we gonna do next? Brows. And I'm gonna do my look a bit decent. I'm gonna use my Real Anastasia Beverly Hills Day Brow in the color Auburn. I'm using my angled brush and I'm dipping it into my dip brow, and I'm gonna form the shape of brow that I want. And these little tiny few things you see there are my brows! They're back! But you can't find them, but they're back! And my dip brow is so freaking cold that it's not dipping. Maybe I can warm it up. It's not working. Yes, it is! It is working. How great is that? And I always have to do this because I've got light coming from that side, which up my sight in my mirror, so I don't see what I'm doing until I do this. There you go. Now I'm gonna try to mimic the same brow on the other side. Okay, I'm getting a concert live! Yay! Let's all sing! Let's sing a Christmas song! Let's sing a Christmas song! And Odie can sing so beautifully along! La 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 la! Ooh, 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 ooh. Well done. That was our Christmas song, live for you. Okay. For people who don't know me yet, the more silly I am, the more pain I have. So, I'm funny today. Yay! I think I'm gonna have to build up my morphine today. Now, these aren't perfect, but I like them. I'm not saying they're perfect, absolutely not, but I'm more finding the spot to get them even. So let's leave it at that. Now, I kept my foundation brush here, my concealing buffer, and I just buffed the beginning of my brows so that it looks a little bit more natural, because I don't want to have those real boxy brows, but that's better. That's more how I like it. And there we go. Now, I'm gonna prime my eyes with an eyeshadow. And this is just a white shimmery eyeshadow, and I even have a brush that I never use for anything else but for this eyeshadow, but I gotta find it first. So I'm looking for that to pick. Ah, there you are. It's my only L thing that I ever had, and it's a brush by L. And I'm gonna start on the inner corner, and I'm gonna do just the inner corner. No, I'm not just gonna do the inner corner, but what I want to achieve is a glitter look. So if I now do my whole eyes with this, and then I'm gonna use concealer or anything else to stick on the glitter, it would be a waste of time and product. So I'm just bringing this beneath my brows as a guideline for highlight. And I also love this eyeshadow for extending everything a little bit, you know. To prime my eyes, I'm taking a fluffier brush. It's by Real Techniques. Can't remember a damn thing today. So, I am taking a very neutral color. It's a real shitty color, literally. I hate this color, so I don't use it for anything but my transition color. And it's perfect. Because you almost don't see it, but it's making life so easy to blend everything. So this is my favorite base. I'm moving on to a flat applying brush, and I'm going to a brown tone. This is the color number 9, matte eyeshadow by Hype. And I'm going to pop that on the outer corners and on top of my crease. Not on the lid, but just above my crease. And not completely to the inner corner. So I'm starting 1 centimeter away from my inner corner, and I'm blending it out higher than my crease. and the width of the brush further than my outer eye corner. And bringing that same line beneath my eyes. So I'm making this line come together with a lower lash line. And it's so amazing, once you've got foundation on, your brows are done, and you just touch your crease with a darker color, you're completely changed. Your look, bam, totally different. Now, I'm cleaning off this brush on a makeup wipe, as I want to use it to put on my glitter too, because we're going for glitter today, ladies and gentlemen. It's a party look, you know? So, when you're going for a party look, go all the way, not just the tiniest bit, just go for it. If you want to go for it, go for it. Don't let anybody stop you. So, I have got here very beautiful shimmery colors, but I also have brown and gold pigment from collection 2000 Dazzle Me. Now, with another small brush, a round applyment brush like this, I'm going to a champagne, a darker than champagne color, and I'm bringing that also on the outer corner here and to the lower lid, because I want to have some shimmer underneath here, but I'm not going to put my glitter down there. So I'm using a very shimmery, yeah, rose gold. Actually, I'm using the darkest color more on the outside, even a bit of the brown, the real brown in this palette, and I am taking that champagne color more to the inner corner. So it's gradient, it's from champagne to rose gold to brown. And it's all nicely blended together. Exactly how I want it to be. You can choose. Either you use an eye primer, you can use any cream, you can use glue, lash glue, you can use concealer, you can use anything you want, and why not just use concealer, as that is the closest at hand. So I'm putting some concealer on the back of my hand, and I'm going to use this round brush to apply that to my moving eyelid. I'm going back to my flat brush, and I'm going to take this lightest pigment, which is the golden one. And with a flat brush, I'm going to tap that on to this concealer to make it stick. And I'm going to hold a tissue or anything underneath. Yeah, I do have a sanitary wipe. Now look at me. I'm going to hold it, not stick it to my face, but just going to hold it and gently tap this gold onto my eyelid. And I'm not too neat in the crease, because I don't want it to be a real cut crease. Now I'm opening the brown color, and I'm just going to take the other side of this brush, tapping into this brown, which hasn't been used before. It's a virgin box! Yay! And I'm going in the middle. I'm going to mix these two already a little bit together before I apply the brown completely on the outer edge. And I'm gonna see if I can already tap on a bit more in that middle part. And if you want to stick, stick that. And of course, now I'm going to take a flat brush that I'm only gonna use for that brown, and it's a smaller one, and I'm gonna tap that onto that concealer so that we have a real dark, glittery outer corner. But I am going to blend. I'm not gonna leave this so harsh, and that's what I'm going for. Perfect. I love it. Now I'm gonna do the same on the other side, so you don't have to wait up for me. I will be back soon. Now I'm taking a very fluffy blending brush, and this is also one by Real Techniques, and I'm gonna blend the edge of those colors onto the crease. So I am mixing it on top of my crease so that it's not a cut crease. Like I said before, I don't want to have a real cut crease. I want to have a blended, nice and beautiful, golden brown, sexy look. Now, I love this. Oh my God, I love this. It's so pretty. It's not over the top. It's not over the hills, but it's so gorgeous. Oh, I love it. I'm taking a very small applying brush, and I'm using this color Meteorite, which I adore, and I'm gonna apply that in my lower lash line, lower than my waterline, because I don't want powder in my eyes today. So I am applying this just above these rose goldish tones that I used before. But I do want to have a nice waterline, but I'm going to use a special pencil for that. And I had found one that I had put ready, but if I put something ready, you know that it's impossible for me to find it again. So I found my NYC City Proof 24 Hours Hydrofuse Waterproof number 625 white shimmery pencil. I'm gonna put that in my waterline. Love that. Now, closing that pencil, where's the tip again? I always lose my tips, but everybody already knows that, so I will come across it when the pencil is molten, melted, whatever you want to name it, whatever it shouldn't be. Once it's that, I will find it. Am I gonna start with mascara and putting glue on my lashes? Yes, that's what I'm gonna do. I am going to wear my favorite lashes of all time. These flary suckers, they're so gorgeous. Once you have seen these on, you will never want to wear any other again. It is so amazing. I have worn these on last Saturday when we had to go to a party, and oh my God, people asked me, how did you do that? What? How could you get your lashes so huge? Well, it's simple, just use the right lashes. But first, I'm gonna apply mascara to my lower lashes and hope that I'm not gonna ruin my beautiful end. As you see, here's the tip of that pencil. I'm gonna use this special comb. It's a mascara comb, not a wand, and I love using this, but I start from the bottom to the top, because I know when I immediately coat my lashes, my face is full of mascara. So now lately I apply my mascara from the bottom to the top. As you all can see, I have put on my lashes off camera as I was shaking like a leaf, and I had to do my lower lashes anyway, so I'm just gonna give them a nice small second coat. But if you don't use black eyeliner, your lashes have to say it all. And if you're not using lower eyelid falsies, your own lashes will do the trick. But you've got to comb them and coat them and give them a lot of love, and blend your own lashes to your falsies, especially when you've got huge suckers like I have on here. Now, I'm gonna plump my lips and I'm gonna do my blush and make my cheeks glow like a disco ball. Now that I have plumped my lip with the lip plumper, normally I use a product which is called Hero Do It. It is a special balm actually against bruises, but I'm gonna use my extra lip plumper, so I'm not gonna use this, but it's a tip. If you bruise easily around your lips from using such a sucking device, use Hero Do It or any product from the pharmacy that works against blue stains, bruises, whatever. But I have my lip gloss ready and I had my pillow plumped right next to it. And it is right in front of me. Okay, we've got ya. So I'm first gonna put on my double extra L pillow plump, this one which I have from eBay. I don't know from who I exactly bought it, but it works amazing. It stains, tingles, but it also works. It's a miracle, and that's what matters to me. So, I'm gonna let that work, and in the meantime, we're going highlight like a disco ball. As I said, we're going for full glow here. I'm gonna start by using a blush that's not too shimmery, but I'm applying that not on the apples of my cheeks, because I'm too old for that. Ladies and gents, if you're aging and you're starting to get wrinkles everywhere and you put red in the middle of your face, you're gonna pull all attention to your wrinkles. So leave your blush on the outer edge on top of your contour. Just on the cheekbones, not on the cheeks itself. Look what a difference in my face that gives. It's such a healthy glow, but nothing in the inner square part of my face. That's all gonna be highlighted and bright. Just a tip for us beautiful aging women. We're not aging, we're getting more mature, like a good wine. We get better every year. It's the fault that counts. Nah. Highlight. And I really want to let it go all the way, so I am taking my Makeup Academy one, my all-time favorite, as you all know, and I'm gonna use my fan brush. No, I'm not gonna use my fan brush. I'm gonna use my round highlighter, which gives so much more pigment. And I'm gonna start on the outer edge here, and look at that glow coming. Look at that. Woo! And that I bring almost completely under the eye, but I'm using it there and then just feathering, you know, because otherwise I'm setting my concealer and I'm getting all wrinkly again. But now let's go over that blush. Give our nose a nice bit of attention this time, and our forehead, our chin, the upper edge of our Cupid's bow. Not that I really have one, but let's pretend. And if you're wearing something like I am now, and there is a little bit of your collarbone visible, highlighted. Don't go without highlighter on your collarbone. If you got an open blouse, absolutely do your entire collarbone. And not to forget, with a blouse like this, the shoulders. Give them a nice golden glow, golden shine. And the light will catch on to them like magic. It's the holiday season, so you can go all the way with this. And I'm looking like a monkey applying that with my wrong hand. That wasn't looking cute. Okay, so make sure that's blended out far enough. I can see all the heads turn when you walk into the room. Wow. There she is. Magic. And that's the magic of this look. You don't have a winged eyeliner. You don't have any black in the makeup itself, except you got black lashes. Now, people, all that's left to do is my lips. And instead of being busy for hours to do our lips, I am just taking this Biocura incredible color. It is such a Christmas color. I am madly in love. It's the color 11, and it's a burgundy copper, a red copper or something, I don't know, but it's so pretty. And I'm gonna put it on top of my plumper, see what it does. If it's not okay, I'll wipe it off. Easy as that. OMG, that's incredible, people. So instead of going for the most vibrant lipstick or anything, or a metallic lip or whatever, this gloss or a gloss in a color like this is so really the cream on your ice cream, you know? The whipped cream on your dessert. Or the topping. If you want to make this really long lasting, put on translucent powder as much as you can so that it's really set and there's no shimmer, no gloss left, and then put on another coat and it will stay all night. You won't have to touch up a lot. There you go. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm gonna put on my wig. I'll be right back. And that will be the final moment of this video with my new background, and it's wonderful. I love it. Oh, so happy. Right back. There you go. With hair. Yay. Now, I see that I am eating lipstick, which is not meant to happen, so I'm just gonna bite it off on a tissue. That's better. So if you set it with translucent powder, you won't have this problem. But as I'm gonna wipe it off in a moment, I'm not gonna. So, to finish off this wonderful holiday look, you can go for up-down hair, which is very, very sexy and hot. You can just let it go. You can put it to one side, you can put in a pin, you can put on a little hat. You can do whatever you want with this look, because it's matching almost everything. Now I'm going to finish it all off with my NYX Matte Finish. Fini Matte. En français. You can never have enough of setting spray. Fan yourself well dry and all your makeup will melt together and you will have the most smooth skin in the world, but you're glowing like that disco ball I mentioned earlier, so you're gonna be the top of the evening. Believe you me. Unless you all do this, then there's nobody gonna be the top of the evening. So, all sparkle together then. You can all play Christmas tree and be a ball, each of you. A disco ball. So, ta-da! I want to thank you all for watching this crazy, silly tutorial with me. And if you're not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. Leave some nice comments down below. And for me, there's only one thing left to say, and that is, my love for makeup is spread all over to you, and I really hope to see you again soon in one of my coming videos. This one, by the way, is Nr3 in my 10 magical party looks for the holidays. So, for now, bye-bye. Keep on laughing, 'cause that's important.